what we got here? New boy on the wing. You look like a pussy boy, black clot. Speak to me, the soldier.
Look, look, I fucking shouldn't be here, yeah? I understand that.
What you mean you shouldn't be here? Nobody should be here.
Yeah, but I really shouldn't be here. You don't understand.
Look, boy, what be your name?
Billy.
What you in for, Billy? Not much by the looks of it.
Look, all I did, I went on my phone pissed up, went on Facebook, some geezer written something fucking stupid about some shit to do with war, soldiers dying and shit. All I wanted to do was scroll down. I accidentally clicked the fucking like button.
There's no way of getting rid of the fucking like. You can't unlike on the fucking BlackBerry, man. And I'm in here. I've got 2 years in here for that. You what, boy? You some pussy who being on Facebook, acting like a real dickhead. You're gonna be my bitch. Get down and suck him on me cock. Yeah, puss clatter road bike.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Talk to the man on the street and see what he's saying. It's Vox Pop.
Vox Pop, Vox Pop, Vox Pop, Vox Pop, Vox Pop, Vox Pop, Vox Pop.
Yes, we're going to find out whether cancer is actually funny. Yes. You there, man on the street, what do you think? Is cancer quite funny?
Well, I guess it depends on the way you look at it. I mean, it has to be certain types of cancer. Cancer of the penis, that's quite funny. Cancer of the boobies.
Boobies are very funny. Absolutely very funny, yes. I love the boobies.
Vox pop, vox pop, vox pop.
Yo, madam, what do you think? Is cancer funny?
Absolutely not. My little boy has anal cancer.
Oh, and cancer of the bum bum.
Oh, actually, it is quite funny, actually, yes. When you say the word bum-bum, it does make it quite amusing.
Yes, I think it is the way you tell it. It definitely is, yes.
Well, I'm going to go tell my little boy that there's a new way to look at his cancer and make everything bright and happy again.
Yes, yes, but don't you be looking too close. You might get a poo-poo in your eye.
Fox pop, fox pop, fox pop.
How about you, young man? Do you think cancer's funny?
Yeah!
Well, can't really argue with that either, yes. Here's the next one.
Fox pop, fox pop, fox pop.
Is paedophilia funny? Or pedophilia, depending on how you want to pronounce it. You, sir, do you think pedophilia is quite funny?
Absolutely not. It's a disgrace. Burn them.
Well, yes, yes, I guess, yeah, I see your point. How about you, madam? Do you think paedophilia is funny?
No, not at all.
Not even if it's with a boy?
What do you mean?
I mean, instead of it being paedophilia on a young girl, some young boys wouldn't mind being pedophile by older women. Say, if you were 10 years old and the Spice Girls broke into your window and raped you in your bed, I can imagine a lot of little boys enjoying it quite a lot, wouldn't you?
That's disgusting.
Yes, but very, very erotic and quite amusing. You'd be going around telling all your friends all about it, wouldn't you? Ew, Scary Spice sat on my face and then Ginger Spice sucked off my plonker whilst Baby Spice fingered my bottom and Sporty Spice lifted some weights in the corner of the room wanking.
Yes, that is quite funny, actually, yes.
Fox pop, fox pop, fox pop.
You, sir, what do you think? Paedophilia, funny or no?
Well, Chris Langham used to be funny, but I haven't seen him on the TV for a while.
Yes, he was very amusing, I must admit, but now I see reruns of his stuff and I just want to throw up in a bucket. It's tainted with his boy-fiddling fuckities.
Fox pop, 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 fox pop.
Oi, you little cunt.
What?
I saw what you did, you little shit.
I ain't done nothing.
I saw you. Come over here and put your hands out. You're under arrest for vandalism.
But you don't understand, bruv.
I understand well enough when I see a little turd chuck a fucking brick through a phone box.
No, no, no. You don't get it, man.
What's there to get? Shut up and put your hands out.
Mate, you can't arrest me. It's my birthday.
Your birthday? Let me see your ID.
Here.
Oh. Well, look at that. So it is. Alright, mate. You're free to go. Sorry about all that feces-related insults. Oh, don't know what I was thinking.
No worries, mate. You weren't to know.
We're now going to take some calls about the photographs taken of the Duchess of Cambridge sunbathing, topless at a French chateau in France. First up, we have Theodore from Byfleet. Hello, Theodore.
Yes, hello, Jeremy.
What's your take on this, sir?
It's a sickening, vile disgrace. Frenchie is a dirty man, and this time Frenchie got dirtier. Dirty, dirty, Frenchie.
I see.
It's disgusting how they can do this to our beloved people's princess. I mean, how would you like it if you had your Samson photographed on your friend's chateau, Jeremy?
None of my friends have chateaus, Theodore.
Preposterous!
Do you not think that such a high-profile person should be a little bit more discreet about where they get naked?
She's a princess! The people's princess! She could do what she likes, when she likes!
Do you not think that someone, how should I put it, someone who cavorts publicity in such a manner is fair game?
Fair game? Are you some sort of crack-smoking, red flag-waving hippie?
No, sir.
Well, stop talking like one, you faggot!
Wow. Strong opinions on this one. Next, we have Dylan from Peterborough. What do you take on this, Dylan?
What a wonderful age we live in, Jeremy. Absolutely wonderful, isn't it?
Am I, sensing some sarcasm there, Dylan?
Well, here's the thing, Jeremy. People are saying this is bringing up the bad old days when Diana was hounded by the paparazzo. But it's a very different thing, Jeremy. A photo like this of Diana back in the day, well, you would have had to have got a plane or a boat over to France just to get your hands on it. But this one, it was up on the internet within hours after being published. Absolutely wonderful. I tell you what, Jeremy, I spent all day that day at work just itching to get home, tune in, turn on, and whack off all over my keyboard. And when I did, I came with a thunder. It was glorious.
Are you for real?
Yes, 100%, Jeremy. Oh, I mean, look at it. The tastiest piece of ass to ever grace the royal persuasion. And we now have a photo of the goodies. The real goodies. Fantastic. I tell you what, I've wanked over it at least, well, I don't know, 20 times already. My son's wanked over it. My dad's wanked over it. I even convinced my wife to whack me off over it a couple of times too.
Really?
Jeremy, wanking is the family way. I come from a proud, long line of wankers. My great-great-grandparents were notorious wankers. Glorious, glorious, notorious wankers. People have been tossing that salad over photographs for hundreds of generations. God save the Queen.
Well, that's lovely to know, but what about the privacy issue?
What? Sorry, Jeremy, just all this talk about the photos. I really got to go and pull my rooster again. Goodbye.
Next caller, I guess.
Mr. Azil Nadir, you are accused of false accounting and theft, totaling over £100 million worth of fraud and evasion of justice for 20 years.
My client accepts the charge of guilty, Your Honour.
Oh, well, that's good. Now I can pass sentence.
I think in such a case, 10 years is appropriate, considering the crime involved.
Objection, Your Honour! That sentence is unfeasibly lenient considering the nature of the crime. The defendant would likely be serving less than 5 years!
Objection denied. 10 years it is.
Oh, I have one objection, Your Honour. You see, it's my client's birthday today.
Oh. Oh dear. Well. Well, case closed. You are free to go. Bailiff, do we have any candles?
Tony and Linda have £40,000 as a budget to buy the house of their dreams.
We've already looked at some squalid hovels and a den of iniquity. Now let's see the wild card. It's the murder house.
Sorry, murder house?
Yes, Tony, murder house. Don't let the name put you off. The murder house is an absolute steal, well within budget, with interesting history and original features.
Yeah, but why is it called... Why do you keep calling it the murder house?
That's right! Let's look inside!
Is that a girl in the window?
No. No, that's not a girl. And this room would be ideal as a guest room. As you can see, the walls are somewhat bleeding, but it is a lovely shade of red and goes really well with the carpets.
Is it a theme room like?
Yes! There is a theme, isn't there? It's very much like Marmite, Tony.
Some people will not find this room for them. But if your guests are the kind of people that enjoy piercing screams in the middle of the night, furniture moving of its own volition, and sleeping 3 foot above the sheets, then this is perfect as it is.
You wouldn't have to change a thing.
And if we didn't want that?
Then I don't recommend sleeping in this room. Like I said, this could be an ideal guest room.
Well, I mean, so far every room has had "I will return to kill again" written in big letters on the walls.
Yes, you would need to redecorate, I admit. Why don't we look at the conservatory?
This conservatory was built after the incident, and as you can probably tell, it's completely activity-free. Think of this as your inner sanctum, your shelter within the storm.
Did you just throw something at me?
No, Linda. Must have been the ghost of the murdered little girl.
Hi, guys. Good to see you all. Just need a quick power snack before we start this meeting.
What?
Right. Stop the meeting. Hold on. I just need to make one important call. Hold on. Hi. Hello? Yeah, I'm fine. Look. I just want to know what the fuck is up with my lunchbox today. No, ma'am. You listen. I said a wagon wheel with jam. J-A-M. I said jam. Jam. All you hear is fuck all when I say fucking jam. Oh, yeah. Well, either I have a speech impediment or you're just a fucking stupid bitch. No. I don't care. I don't fucking care. I'm in a very important meeting right now. You made me very stressed. No, apologise to me later. You've done enough damage already. Just remember, I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry this had to happen too. Right, love you. Right, okay. As you can see, in the third quarter, we have a dip.
Get off me, you brute. Don't touch me. I'll call the police.
Shut up, love. It's my birthday.
Oh, stick it any hole you like, sailor.
No, Akbar, have you seen the Facebook?
No, what is it saying?
A man called Colin from Kingdom of Altrincham say, on status update, Allah is a poo-poo.
Allah is a poo-poo? What is this brazen disrespect of the one true God?
This man cannot have seen Allah. How can he be a judge of what matter Allah is made from?
It certainly would not be poo-poo. Not once in the Quran does it mention anything to do with poo-poo.
What can be done at this malicious violation?
Martyrdom. First we bomb all the Western embassies. Then we bomb Facebook.
But of course, Akbar, of course. But how do we bomb the Facebook?
We travel to California. We will fly a plane. And we will fly it right into Zuckerberg Jew's face.
Indeed.
And our word from our new sponsor, the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Please, stop writing to us. We have many funds available, but none for such sponsorship as a show as yours. These funds are reserved for dying sick children. P.S. We are not giving away their go-karts.
Like this, Zuckerberg.
So, as you're probably well aware, Facebook HQ has been hit by a Boeing 747 in a jihadist suicide attack. It killed all of its staff and founder Mark Zuckerberg. Facebook has been offline now for almost 24 hours, and already there's been 6,000 suicides across the globe.
We are now taking calls. First up, we have David from Dagenham. Hello, David.
Jeremy, the world is in a dire strait. I cannot believe what just happened. It really is time we put our foot down on these Muslims. They are just being bloody ridiculous. Pardon my French, parlez-vous. Absolutely ridiculous, I tell you. I mean, what kind of pathetic, simple-minded people react to a silly little Facebook comment in such a manner?
Do you think they went a bit too far then, I take it?
Oh, just a little bit, Jeremy. I mean, to go as far as what they did over a Facebook comment, I mean, do you really take Allah is a poo-poo so literally that you bomb people to death? It is ridiculous. People should say what they want on Facebook and be left alone.
Very true. Next caller is Julie from Tyneside. By the way, thanks, David. Hello, Julie.
I can't check in, Lee. I can't fucking check in!
Oh, Julie gone. I think Julie's gone. Good luck logging in, Julie. There is a Facebook helpline for everybody missing their status updates. We'll give you that number in just a moment.
Hi, you're through to Pippa's phone. Can't take your call at the moment. Please leave a message after the beep. Hi, it's Kate. No one's talking about you now, are they, bitch?
Yes, today we're joined by comedian and television personality, Matty Martok. Hello, Matty.
Hey, you alright, boss?
Now, Matty, a lot of people have described your material as, how can I put it, immature, the lowest common denominator, and lacking any sort of intelligent observation upon the world around us. How do you react to these criticisms?
Well, it's bloody bollocks, isn't it, right? I mean, I can do all kinds of stuff. It's just what they ask I to do. You aren't political, or it gives you political.
Do go on.
I mean, right, David Cameron. He smells of shit. Political! Gordon Brown. He looks like a flump. Political! George Bush Sr., George Bush Jr., right, couple of dickheads. Political!
Right, is that it?
No, I can do anything like surrealist. I can do all that Mighty Bush shit, right? Fucking Ian Holloway as a balloon. Abstract. Fucking a spider made out of cheese strings. Abstract.
I could do observational comedy.
You know when, like, you're fingering your fucking cousin and you find your bloody dad's wedding ring up her asshole? Observational. Hey, about this one, right? Herbal essence in shampoo. Don't make birds come in the shower no more. Observation!
You've really laid those rumours to rest. And fully put those critics in their place, Matty. Thank you.
No problem, boss! Sarcasm!
And who be you, Arabic-looking boy?
Look, I didn't do nothing wrong. I shouldn't be here.
I've been getting a lot of that this week. Every man should be here. You committed a crime, you be here. Me killed four man, you be here. Why you be here?
I said on Facebook, you know, all soldiers should die and go to hell.
What? You know me be a soldier. You want a soldier like me dead and go to hell. Bitch, I'm going to give you a couple of years, you're never going to forget. No man disrespects a soldier like me like that.
Hi, you're through to Pippa's phone. Can't take your call at the moment. Please leave a message after the beep. Yeah, it's Kate again. Just to remind you. Oh, who's that? Who's that coming on my tits? The fucking king!
You want it right, I like it tight.
top, yeah, I like to weep.
Yeah.
Told the truth, I don't really like to weep. Patience is a virtue, but she give me time to really to weep. Really like the time, special kind of breed. I know she on my mind. An independent lady that remind me of my mom at times. I ain't even gonna lie, still, yeah, she on my mind. But still, you know I like it tight. Every time she come on tight, oh shit, ride me like a bike. What? I must have got caught off her vibes. I ain't even gonna lie, so I'm on my time.
Tight, tight, tight. I said, yes,
yeah, she
like it. Right, right, right.
Yeah,
I like it. Tight, tight, tight.
Smile, the way you look and how you smell. Shape like the number 8. Figure looking all so nice. Give it to you Friday day to Sunday night. Don't wanna let you out of my sight. When we together spark fly, time slips the mind. As our vibes are real tight, like we've known each other for a longer time. Not just a bang, but someone I turn to for advice.
Pussy lie, my look alike. When I spray my bullet like I'm fucking in a fight. On a high dick digging between the fucking thighs. Pretty eyes when I see a bloody body. Fucking smile like I pick a bride. Not to fucking wine, not to dine, not to be eating. Like I'm on a fucking flight. Take it on the night, spread your leg. I boss a wine, I boss a wine, I boss a wine, I boss a wine. Tight, tight, I said, you want it right, right, right. I like it tight.
Nice girls, from sweet girls to filthy dirty spice girls. Show that girl things she never done before. Make a princess my freaky dirty whore. Bend the girl over, she'll touch them toes. Then I'll come in her ear and blow bubbles out her nose. Pussy so hot that you'll swear it glows. Get so wet, it starts to overflow. Lick her downstairs, her body be trembling.